Hello, my name is James Ritchie Carroll, and today we're going to show you how to install the openPDC 2.0 on a substation style computer. Here on my desk I have a Schweitzer 3355. It's a dual core 64-bit processor box with 8 gigabytes of RAM. Nice piece of hardware. No fans, so it's a fanless computer. You see the heat sinks in the front. And we're going to walk through the installation process and show you the level of difficulty for setting this up and using it inside of a substation. So first things first, you need to go get the OpenPDC. Pull up a search engine, type in OpenPDC. Here you go, openpdc.com. Click on Downloads. We're going to get the OpenPDC version 2.0, and we are going to download it. We're going to get the installs zip file. Once you have the software unzipped, you just double click on the setup exe. When you click finish, the next thing that's going to happen is going to run the configuration setup utility. The configuration setup utility is used to sort of set up the OpenPDC environment. So inside of a substation, we're going to set up a new configuration. It's going to use a database, but we don't have to install SQL Server or MySQL or Oracle. We can use something called SQLite, which is a local database that requires no installation. Very handy for substation computers. And the configuration ends up in one file that's easy to back up. Click Next. Setup is in progress. Everything succeeded. Next again. And Finish. The OpenPDC is up and running, and the next thing that happens is it's installing the PMU connection tester. So we'll walk through that install while the OpenPDC starts up. So we're going to click Next, and just click Next a couple of times, and now the connection tester is installed, and the OpenPDC is installed. So we'll go validate now also that the connection tester is running and operational, and it is. That's good. All right. So now you have an operational OpenPDC and OpenPDC Manager. So what has happened is when we installed the OpenPDC sort of out of the box, it came with a sample file. That sample file is just repeating over and over showing a single PMU device. But in reality, you're inside of a substation, you need to connect to a real device. So it's maybe hard to see, but over here to my left, we have a Schweitzer 421. So down here you can see the 421, and I have a serial cable connected to it. So I'm going to take the serial cable and we'll connect it to the back of my substation computer. So now we have the device connected. Let's verify that it has connectivity by running the PMU connection tester. So in this case we have a serial connection to our Schweitzer on COM1. Its baud rate is 57,600, no parity, one stop bit. We're doing C37118, and the device ID is number 1. We click Connect, and there we go. We have data. Now, since I have validated connectivity, I'm just going to go ahead and jump over straight to the OpenPDC and set up this new device. Inside the OpenPDC, you can click on the Add New Device button right from the home page. When you do that, you can build your connection string. Again, serial, we said it was 57600, no parity, one stop bit, save. The device ID code that we had selected was number 1, C37118 is our protocol, click Next. We're going to get the configuration, and there it is. Click Next, you can see the device, and click Finish, and now the device should be up, running, and connected. We can validate that by going to Monitoring and Graph Measurements, and open up Ritchie's PMU, and you already see data. I'm going to click on the frequency, but you can see some data coming out of the device. Now the second thing you may want to do is get rid of Shelby, this little Shelby test device. So I'm going to click on the Edit button beside Shelby, click Delete. Now our little sample device is gone, and the only thing we're left with is Ritchie's PMU. So now we've got a PMU up and running in the substation without any issues. There you go. You can see the device is happily connected. Now the next thing you might want to do inside of a substation is actually update the configuration for a device. So now we go to Home, We're going to browse our devices. I've got one device, and you'll notice on this screen that says Richie's PMU, and over to the right there's a little button that says Update Configuration. We're going to click that. When you click Update Configuration from the device, you can re-request its configuration. Now, the updated configuration has been requested. Click Next. All the updated parameters will now be available. So if any of this information has changed, it'll show up in the list. New signals, new device information will be available. Click Finish, and now the configuration has been changed. So with this step, you've done all the possible things you need to do with a substation device, substation PMU. You've added a new one, you've deleted one, and you've updated an existing one. With those three steps, we've walked through the exercise of actually managing the openPDC in a substation and managing your field devices through that PDC. So that's it. That's how you get the openPDC 2.0 up and running in your control center environment. So we're very excited about this build of the openPDC, and we think it's very easy to use. We hope you do too. If you have any more questions, please visit the openPDC website, which is openpdc.com, or you can visit our website at thegridprotectionalliance.org. Thanks. Have a great day.